Haiti's tremor was 300 times smaller than the biggest earthquake ever recorded. Yet its impact has been one of the most devastating, claiming as many as 200,000 lives, with the death toll still rising.
All of my friends are still in there. They are screaming, but I couldn't do anything for them. My girlfriend, my pet sister, and everybody's all in there.
And the earthquake has left 1.5 million people homeless. Geologist Roger Billum is investigating how this earthquake happened and why so many people died. Amidst the destruction, he makes a tragic observation.
Earthquakes aren't deadly, it's the buildings that are deadly. In this district, about 1 in 3 buildings has collapsed. It's a tragedy beyond belief.
The intense shaking demolished 50% of the buildings. Debris blocked roads in and out of the city. As news of the disaster spread around the world, earthquake specialists began to assess the damage. In a laboratory in London, earthquake engineer Dr. Tiziana Rossetto is surveying the destruction of Port-au-Prince from space, feeding back vital information about access routes and wreckage to help rescue workers on the ground.
Here we have the main cathedral in Port-au-Prince, and this is a pre-earthquake image, and here we have a post-earthquake image, and you can see from this that it's lost its roof.
No structures were left unscathed, but the specific design of each building determined the way they collapsed.
In this case, the structure seems to have failed through what we call a pancake failure. The vertical elements, or the columns, have collapsed, and therefore the floors have pancaked one on top of each other, causing total collapse of the structure and probably quite a lot of life loss.
On the ground, Billum has discovered that the soft sedimentary rock on which the city was built intensified the shaking during the quake. And also, he spots simple details in the construction of these heavy concrete buildings that led to the enormous death toll.
What we're looking at here is the splintered wreck of a 3 or perhaps 4-story building that has pancaked. All the vertical columns have collapsed one way or the other, and the floors have just shut down, squashing everything in between. And there are thousands of buildings like this.
The building's reinforced concrete pillars reveal why it crumpled during the earthquake.
If you look carefully, there's very little steel in this column. And it's actually snapped off here and here. This whole column should have had 2, 3, 4 more of these verticals.
The lack of robust steel rods made this building's concrete framework a death trap.
Concrete supports the building, but without sufficient steel, well, the whole thing can be shaken to pieces. And this is actually broken off at the joint between the floor and the vertical column.
The horrific way in which these buildings collapsed was captured by a survivor just moments after the earthquake. Inadequate construction has claimed the lives of up to 200,000 people in Haiti. But sadly, the scale of this tragedy was preventable. Since the massive destruction caused by the 1906 San Francisco earthquake, engineers have been investigating how buildings dynamically react to intense shaking. Using shaking tables, big enough to take an entire block of flats, engineers have been able to simulate earthquakes and identify inherent weak spots in a building's design.
We all live in stacked cubes. And cubes have a particular weakness. And the problem with cubes is they're held up by their corners. This building has very strong columns and beams, but very weak corners. And as a result, when the earthquake shaking occurs, which is basically side-to-side motion, it shakes very hard. The earthquake also produces torsion. Look how weak this building is in response to torsion. And the earthquakes occasionally produce up and down motion, compression of that building. It's also weak.
The knowledge gained from these experiments has helped engineers to design technologies which protect buildings against tremors. From reinforced frameworks to floating foundations which dampen the vibrations. Today, construction in American quake zones must adhere to strict regulations, ensuring that buildings are what engineers call life-safe during an earthquake. These precautions proved vital in 1994, when the city of Los Angeles was hit by a magnitude 6.7 quake. The violent shaking which followed lasted 20 seconds. In stark contrast to Haiti, although these life-safe buildings were damaged by the quake, people walked out alive. There were only 72 deaths. The problem is, many of the lessons learned by the earthquake engineers are too expensive to put into practice in developing countries. The 2005 earthquake in Kashmir, northern Pakistan, measured 7.6 on the Richter scale. It shook the ground vigorously for 2 minutes, with horrific consequences. In some places, up to 80% of the buildings collapsed, killing entire families in an instant. The earthquake claimed over 85,000 victims, many crushed inside their own homes. Most of these buildings had been built in an ad hoc fashion, with no regulations to ensure that they would be safe during an earthquake. And the construction of buildings in Port-au-Prince had similar fatal flaws.
Port-au-Prince, like many big and rapidly growing cities in developing countries, was particularly vulnerable to earthquakes because, as a population centre, it had grown very rapidly, so new homes were built very quickly without thought to any earthquake codes, if they even exist, building codes. As cities grow, they also start to use more and more marginal land. So, for example, people will build on unstable slopes which could landslide during earthquakes. So as a city grows rapidly, you can expect the building stock to be pretty poor, and you can also expect those buildings to be in areas which are much more susceptible to the effects of an earthquake.
Haiti is the poorest nation in the Western Hemisphere, and much of the country will have to be rebuilt from scratch. But there are simple and affordable ways to make Haiti's buildings safe in the future.
This is the vulnerability of all buildings that are made of cubes, the corners. So now here is the exact same building I just showed you, but I've snapped in these little corner joints. Now look, I shake the building back and forth, nothing.
By simply connecting the corners of each floor to the vertical columns with steel reinforcement, a building can be made life-safe.
This building, which is just 15% more material and 15% higher cost, is now bulletproof when it comes to earthquakes. And that's the difference between a disaster and a building that survives strong corners.
This building did not need to fall down. The same materials assembled correctly would have left a perfectly intact building here. The people that assembled it had no idea that it might kill their descendants, and that's unfortunately what it's done. There's a building right next to it. All the people in it walked out and marveled at the shaking. People in this building probably haven't walked out at all. Really, really depressing.
When Haiti is rebuilt, it will be vital the buildings are made life-safe, as scientists are warning Haiti will be hit by earthquakes again. And worryingly, the next time could be bigger and of an entirely different nature.